This is the VOA Special English Economics Report. Officials in Washington recently lost a ruling over their power to enforce competition on the internet. Now the Federal Communications Commission has a new plan. The FCC currently defines high-speed internet as an information service. As such, its powers to set rules for broadband service have never been clearly recognized. But telephone service is a recognized area for the agency to regulate. So the FCC proposes to redefine broadband as a telecommunications service. Congress could give the agency clearer powers over broadband. But FCC Chairman Julius Genachowski calls his plan a third way. He says the commission would act narrowly and enforce only parts of existing law. He says the government is not regulating the internet. The changes are meant to support net neutrality, the idea that all web traffic should be treated equally. The ruling by a federal appeals court in April involved internet service provider Comcast. The judges ruled that the FCC had no legal basis for an effort to keep Comcast from limiting access to some services over its network. The company said file-sharing users were slowing its traffic. Broadband providers say regulating them would hurt investment. Verizon Communications called the chairman's plan legally unsupported. As it happens, the plan was announced on May 6th, the same day as the flash crash on American stock markets. The Dow Jones Industrial Average briefly suffered a severe drop. On May 18th, the Securities and Exchange Commission announced new circuit breakers to support orderly trading. The plan involves the Standard & Poor's list of 500 stocks. Stock exchanges have agreed to temporarily halt trading of any stock that rises or falls 10% or more within 5 minutes. The rules will be re-examined in 6 months and could be expanded. And in another development, the Senate voted on May 20th to permit final debate and a vote on a financial reform bill. The House of Representatives has passed its own bill already. The House and Senate versions will need to be combined into final legislation for President Obama to sign into law. The proposed changes in financial rules are the most extensive since the 1930s. The President says the aim is not to punish banks, but to protect the larger economy and the American people. And that's the VOA Special English Economics Report.